representing Japan, taking on Dead Geek, representing North America. Dead Geek has found their stride recently, dominant since the beginning. Let's get started on Inkblot Art Academy. In orange for Dead Geek, they're going to go with the heavy splatling, two splatter shots, and a slosher. Meanwhile, for Dynamu in the turquoise, you've got a splatter shot throw, a slosher, a charger, and a roller. In early action, Dynamu getting out to the middle of splat zone, but Dead Geek has the chance. It's going back and forth early on, Ashley.
I think we're going to see Dynamon head up to that top area and really kind of establish himself up top. But it's splatted! Witch takes him out!
Critical splat by Witch, because you saw Dynamu try to time up the Ink Storm when Dynamon climbs to the top. Akubato getting the splat right now, trying to push back Deadbeat. Right now, you've got Dynamu in the middle of that splat zone with an 83-100 advantage, 3-3 on the field.
Yeah, Akubato's trying really hard to get some ink on the ground there, try to take that splat zone. I think that big, giant chunk of orange is the last thing keeping them from taking it over. And, I mean, honestly, they lost control, but can they hold?
With Deadbeat gonna go ahead and seize control as they get a hold. Bucket of orange ink in the middle of the splat zone, 86-61, 30-second penalty for Dynamu. Now let's see if Deadbeat can push back Dynamu. 4-3 on the field, Special ready to go for power and that heavy splatling whenever he chooses to do so. Here comes some tension missiles to try and keep Dynamu at bay. No success there. However, Deadbeat gonna take the early lead. 40 left, 4-4 on the field, but you see three specials ready for Dynamu as they get set to make that ink storm in the middle of the zone.
Yeah, that was the way for them to sort of push forward, because for a while there, I mean, they were doing Deadbeat was doing a really good job keeping Dynamu out from that splat zone.
61-39, and Dynamu has control of the splat zone as they start to get that timer to tick down. That penalty is now down to just 15 seconds. 4-3 advantage on the field for Dynamu as we see Tim trying to go up this ink-proof ramp. It's going to slow him down a little bit, trying to flank on Dynamon. Dynamon going to make it rain, though, by flicking that Dynamo roller and using that horizontal and vertical flick to cause some damage.
I mean, that vertical flick is brutal, and he really just uses it to its maximum effectiveness.
However, Deadbeat with the lead, 39-57. However, no penalty for Dynamu as that timer starts to tick. Really close to a tie here, 46-39. It's going to be Dynamu that's going to try and take the lead unless Deadbeat can do something. And that's the lead. Oh, just at the last second. Deadbeat able to get it. Deadbeat trying to seize control, 39-38. Deadbeat trails Dynamu, 35-second penalty. Control in the middle right now for Deadbeat. Deadbeat 3-1 on the field for Deadbeat. Here goes Wick going to the top of the tower, trying to keep Dynamu at bay.
Yeah, you can see he's splashing that area next to the ink-proof ramp, and he's just trying to keep out Dynamu, saying, hey guys, like, you're gonna have to not only get through here, but you have to now paint, you've gotta eat that ramp.
And Deadbeat goes and takes the lead, but they only get it by 1 point as Dynamu. Now facing a 40-second penalty, but then Deadbeat's gonna seize control of this splat zone, trying to keep Dynamu at bay. Hexa gonna drop down. Meanwhile, here comes Wick with that splosher, and you've got the ink storm.
The ink storm happening.
That's
here.
Trying to cover the area right there. It's splat zone, still up for grabs at this point. 22-38 advantage. Deadbeat still up.
Wow, big splash.
Aggressive.
Wow.
Splat right there. That is huge. As it's now 4-2 on the field. Dynamu gonna seize control of the splat zone, sitting on top of that tower. However, they have a stiff 28-second penalty to overcome. Here comes the tension missiles and the territory in the middle. That splat zone gonna be re-seized by Deadbeat. Frantic match that we have here, actually.
Yeah, absolutely. Akubaro absolutely just going bananas right now. Inking, splatting, getting all over the place. He's all over the shop. It is incredible to watch him play. And you know what? He's not panicking. That's exactly how he's splatting all these people.
Akubaro normally averages 20 splats per match. You can see how an individual effort can turn the tide. 38-22. However, just 4 seconds left in that penalty for Dynamu. Slight lead for Deadbeat. However, Dynamu keeping that timer going down. 22-28. Dynamu trying to reset. Great defense by Deadbeat. They're able to reset. Yeah. 47 seconds left. 40-second penalty for Dynamu. Oh, wow. Meanwhile, you're Deadbeat. You just have to play some defense and keep Dynamu out of the zone. Akubaro going to take advantage of that one-on-one. But here comes a splashdown. Power with the splashdown. 30 seconds left. 22-25. Penalty going down for Deadbeat. And you've got Dynamu trying
to start taking.
But the specials by Deadbeat really helping out right now, Ash.
Yeah, absolutely. They have got to take control. Dynamu's got to take control back if they're taking their own in this.
25-22 Dynamo, though, with a 40-second penalty. Can they retake control of the splat zone? 10 seconds left. This might be headed into overtime. We'll see. It's still up for grabs. First team to seize control. And in control with 34 seconds left. We're going to certainly go to overtime here. Now, Debbie can take control of the splat zone. It's going to be over. Look at the victory. 20 seconds left. Dynamo, they just need to hold it up. We see the taking missiles. They lost control. Can Debbie seize control? Overtime, taking control of the splat zone inside the special. Well timed use of those for Deadbeat here, actually.
So good, so well coordinated. I mean, they are